the poses is for YouTube, just FYI.
Hey, beautiful people. Welcome back to another video. I know it's been a while since I posted. I did this look on live yesterday, so we finna get right into it. My brows is already done. I'm right now priming my eyelids with the rest of the concealer that's on my brush. All right, so now I'm working out of my eyeshadow palette painted for the back row, and I'm going to start placing that black right on the outer corner of my eyelid, y'all, just giving it a little, like, wing. Whenever you are trying to create a shape with shadow, you want to make sure you use a small packing brush. It gives you more control over that shadow. So now I'm just going to start blending it out with a fluffy blending brush and blowing out those edges, making sure I don't have any harsh lines. Now I'm just going to soften up that black with some brown. So I'm going to add some brown to those edges and start blowing it out with a softer blending brush. It's not usually what I always do, but whenever I use a dark shadow, especially a black, I always try to go back in with a lighter eyeshadow to diffuse those harsh lines as well. So I will always like blend it out with a brown. A brown will always diffuse that black, make it nice and smooth, and make that transition seamless. Just to make sure that black is popping, I'm going to reapply it with that small brush I used in the beginning. And I'm just going to apply it to the edges of my eye, just to make sure it's nice and pigmented. I also do this step to make sure that when I do cut my crease is super sharp. Whenever you are cutting a crease and using a dark shadow, you just want to make sure that that crease is nice and dark, so when you cut it, it's super defined. Using a P. Louise blank canvas base, I'm going to start cutting out my crease, and I'm going to be using a concealer brush. Whenever you are doing a cut crease, just make sure you use the flattest concealer brush you have. This is not a flat concealer brush. That's why I'm taking my time with this cut crease and patting it into the shape, because I really want to make sure that I don't go outside the area that I want to create this crease with. So whenever you are doing a cut crease, just always make sure you are using a very flat concealer brush. It always helps. And take your time by just patting in the shape, not swiping it real quick, because you can control it better. Alright, so going in with my Chakra Sensation palette by Rich Glamour Cosmetics. They have the most pigmented colors in this palette, and they have the perfect blue that I'm looking for. So I'm just going to use a flat packing brush and start packing on this color. Look how very pigmented this blue is. Like, it's unbelievable. I absolutely love this palette. Taking a small concealer brush, I'm just gonna go in with that blue pigment and just start packing in that line to make sure I don't go above that line. I wanna keep the shape that I created with that cut crease. After that, I'm gonna go in with a black shadow and just start blending out those edges. Now we're finna get into the fun part. I'm going in with my NYX glitter adhesive, and I'm gonna start patting this on my eyelid with my finger. Now I'm gonna go in with Stay Golden Cosmetics, and I'm gonna use their Blue Skylar glitter and place that right on my eyelid. After placing that on my eyelid, I went in with some Duo lash glue and I start applying that to my eyelid. I like to do this method if I'm using two different glitters, because I feel like
If I put NYX glitter adhesive on my eyelid twice, it's not going to stick as good. And the dual lash glue is pretty much clear, so you can still see the fine glitter that I used in the first part. Now I'm just going in with some Pond's moisturizer. You want to make sure you prep your skin before applying your makeup, y'all. Now I'm using e.l.f. hydrating primer, y'all. I fell in love with this primer. It leaves your skin so soft and smooth. It fills your pores up and it mattifies your face. I absolutely love this primer. I fell in love with it. After that, I did mix two foundations. I used my Fenty Beauty foundation and I used in the shade 360 the soft pro filter foundation, soft matte pro filter, and then I used some NARS radiant foundation in the shade dark 2, and I start applying that to my face. I mixed it up and it is a perfect match. After that, I'm going in with my foundation brush from Juvia's Place and I'm going to start patting that foundation into my skin. This brush is a must when it comes down to foundation, liquid foundation, y'all. It is absolutely amazing and it's probably good with powder foundation. Like, I'm in love with this brush. It's so soft. Now, I did go in with my Kryolens Concealer Circle, and that I went in with a lighter shade to place right in the inner corner of my eye, and I started blending it out. I don't know what happened to that footage. I think that the video, my camera stopped, but I'm using a Real Technique brush to blend out that concealer underneath my eye. When you are blending out your concealer underneath your eye with a Real Technique brush, just make sure you use very soft motions and allow your concealer to get a little bit tacky before blending it out, which gives you full coverage. Taking a darker concealer to contour my nose and face, I'm going to start at the bridge of my nose and just place this all the way down to the tip of my nose, and I'm going to do that on both sides. Whenever you are contouring, just keep in mind that you do need to use maybe a shade or two darker than your regular skin tone. Going back in with some Tarte Tape Shape Concealer to just brighten up the inner corners of my eyes and the side of my nose. And I'm going to take a Real Technique brush to just blend that out. Taking my dual lash glue, y'all know this is my favorite glue to use for lashes. I'm taking this and applying it to my regular lashes because I've already applied it to my falsies. Going in with my Laura Mercier setting pattern, this is in the shade Translucent. I'm using a Real Technique brush to pretty much set this, my T-zone area, which is the highlighted area underneath my eyes, my face, and bridge my nose. Taking my powder puff, I'm gonna start baking underneath my eyes as well. Using my NYX Jumbo Liner, I'm just applying that on my waterline with a lip applicator. Whenever I use glitter and big lashes, I like to use a white liner to open up my eyes so they won't seem so small. Going in with a blue shadow, I'm just going to start smoking out right underneath of my waterline to make that white pop a little bit more. Mm-hmm. taking a small liner brush and using my Suva Beauty water activated liner in the shade Panda, and I'm gonna start applying a small line right on the crease of my eye, making like a slanted wing. Using Wet n Wild mascara to coat my bottom lashes, I'm gonna put about 2 or 3 coats on them. Now it's time to dust off the powder. So I'm going on my foundation brush. Usually this is how I press the powder in, by using my old foundation brush with no product on it and just pressing it in. So that's what I'm doing to make sure everything is nice and blended and the powder is removed. Going in with my bronzer palette by Pimpy, I'm going to be using the Tropical Vacay palette to pretty much bronze my face, warm it back up. I like to do this method using a soft, fluffy, slanted brush, so that's what I'm doing. I'm using a very soft powder brush, and it is slanted, and I'm going to use this to contour and bronze my face up. It's time to highlight the side of the nose, so I'm using my E30 brush by Morphe. This is my favorite brush I use to highlight my nose. And I'm going in with my Laura Mercier setting powder, and I'm going to just start snatching that nose. Using a brown lip liner to line my lips, and I'm gonna start placing P. Louise base in the shade Tangy Tease right in the middle to create that ombre effect. Taking Morphe setting spray to set my face, I'm gonna just spray it all over my face. Taking Rich Glamour Cosmetics Just Bronze Me palette to highlight my cheekbones and the tip of my nose. Thank you guys so much for watching. This is the finished look. I really appreciate you guys subscribing to my channel. For everybody that is new, welcome. Thank you so much for joining. Make sure you turn the notification bell on to be notified whenever I upload and post new videos. And until the next video, y'all, see you later. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And see you in the next video.